So now let's take a look at the code that makes up the homepage for this app. So here's the homepage. It has a couple of buttons. It has the field where you can enter your name. You can click the buttons and you get the greeting. And in this case, the greetings are shown just inside an alert box. Now, one thing I want to emphasize is that you can have the Endpoints APIs and use the APIs Explorer even if your application doesn't have a front end, if it doesn't have a web page or anything. If you're just running complete back end service, you can use the APIs Explorer to test your APIs. But now, onto the front end. So let's look at the code for index.html. So first of all, we include the file hello.js, which includes the JavaScript functions that our web app's going to use in its front end. And then, and this is really important, we include this file, appys.google.com/js/client.js. This is the file that includes the JavaScript client library. If you don't include this file, you won't be able to use endpoints in your front end. And the client libraries provide the glue that lets your app use endpoints. So you'll also notice that after we bring it in, when the onload's successful, we call the init function. And this init function is actually defined in hello.js. We'll look at that in just a minute. The rest of this page is not so exciting. We have a heading. Then we have the field for the buttons. So this one here is input greet generically, and this one here is input greet by name. We also have the field where we let the user enter their name, and that's the name field. And that's pretty much all this file has. One thing to note, though, is that the onClick of the button doesn't have a real value. This is actually a fake value. So when we load the page the first time, these buttons don't have any onClick action set. And the reason for that is when these actions are loaded, they're going to need to use endpoints. They're going to use your endpoint functions, and your endpoint functions can't be loaded until after the Google Client Library is loaded. So you want to load the Google Client Library first, and then you need to initialize some things, and then you can set the action for your buttons. Okay, let's take a look at hello.js. So up here, these are just some good resources to read. After the Google JavaScript Client Library is loaded, then this init function is going to be called. And really all this does is it loads your Hello World Endpoints APIs. See here this gappy.client.load. This is calling functions in the Google JavaScript Client Library to load your endpoint function. So when you call gappy.client to load your endpoint functions, you specify the endpoint functions to load, you specify the version, you specify a callback to call after your endpoint functions have loaded, and then you must specify the root path, which is the path to your endpoints API. And you can construct that root path like this, which is basically wherever your app's running, add /ah/API. Now, if you leave off the root path, the load function will work, or it'll seem to work, but when you go to call your endpoints APIs, the execution calls won't work. And that's because the Google Client Library will be looking in the Google Public APIs instead of looking at the endpoint APIs for your app. So do make sure you specify the root path. Okay, so after we load the Hello World Endpoints API, we're going to call the load callback function. Here's the load callback. Very simple, it just enables the buttons. It might do other things in other apps, but here all we do is enable the buttons. The enable buttons function uses straight up JavaScript to set the actions on the buttons. So we get the button that you click to greet generically, and we set the onClick action to be the greet generically function. And then we change the value of the button, the label of the button, so that the user knows that it's ready for action. And then similarly, we get the greet by name button, and we set the action when it's clicked to be greet by name. And again, we change the label. And just a reminder that we enable the buttons here instead of setting them in index.html, because these functions, greet generically and greet by name, won't be active until after the Hello World Endpoints API has been loaded. And you can't load that until after you've loaded the JavaScript client library. So you don't want the user to be clicking on the buttons before everything's ready. Okay, so more interestingly, the greet generically function illustrates how to issue a call to one of your own endpoint APIs. So you construct the request. You need to start with gappy.client. You specify the endpoints API to call, which in this case is Hello World Endpoints, and then the actual functional method, which is say hello. So you construct the request, and then you execute the request. And that's all you have to do to issue the call. You also need to specify a callback to call to process the response when the request is executed. And similarly, greet by name does the same thing, only here we get the name out of the name field. We issue the request, gappy.client.helloworldendpoints.sayhello. And here we do pass the name to the request. And this is how you construct parameters to endpoint functions. Specify the parameter and then the value. And you could add, if we had more, you could add more here. So for example, you could add a second arg2 and specify the value to be value 2. And then again, you execute the request. We're going to call the same callback when our request is successful. Okay, so here's the callback that gets called when our request is executed successfully. And we process the response. And the response is always passed to the callback. In this case, all we do is throw up a dialog box, use the alert function, throw up a dialog box, and get the message field out of the response. And going back real quick to the Java, to the Hello class, recall that the Hello class has a message field. The Hello World Endpoint APIs that we've defined so far all return a Hello class object, so our response is going to have a message field. So now you know how to define endpoint functions in Java and how to call them from JavaScript in your UI.